Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at using QuickTime Player to record your screen. So I'm often asked, how do I record the screen when I'm making the MacMost video podcast? For instance, do I use something like ScreenFlow or Camtasia, both of which are excellent screen recording software apps? And matter of fact, I'm using ScreenFlow right now to record the screen because I'm going to demonstrate the way I make most of my videos, which is not to use those apps, but instead simply to use QuickTime Player. Some people don't realize that you can record the screen with QuickTime Player. I'm just going to run it right now. This is the standard QuickTime Player that comes with your Mac, and it is something that every Mac has. And every version of macOS 10 has added features to. And in the last couple of versions of macOS 10, we've got the ability to go File and New Screen Recording. And when you do that, you get a little box like this, and it shows the microphone is being picked up. You can actually click here and select the microphone that you want, and also whether or not you want to show mouse clicks while recording, which I do. And a lot of people notice that there's little circles that appear over the mouse clicks. So let's go ahead, and I'm going to hit record, and now I have the option to click to record the full screen, or I can drag for part of the screen. So let's start by recording the full screen. I'm just going to click here, and let's say I want to do something where I'm just showing how I can drag files and folders around there. You can see I've got this little circle with a box inside of it. I can click on that, and that stops the recording, and it instantly opens up what I recorded inside of QuickTime Player. And now I can actually play it back. Say I want to do something, and I can scrub through it, and I could even go and do some standard QuickTime stuff, like for instance I can trim it there, and so I can get some stuff off the beginning and the end. I'm not going to do that with this particular one. And then I can either export it or simply just save it. And now I can save it out as a QuickTime movie. And it saves it as a pretty compact QuickTime movie. I like this method of doing it because instead of saving it as a file, and if I don't want to keep it, now I have to go and find that file and delete it. Instead now I can actually just see what it is and not save it if I don't want to keep it. And that's actually how I make a lot of these podcast episodes, is I will record a small segment, and if I don't like what I've said or how I've said it or something I've shown on the screen was unexpected, I simply don't save it and I start again. And so when I'm saving it, I'm only saving clips that I'm going to use, and then I edit them together either in iMovie or Final Cut, and that's how I make the videos. You notice here that I've got right there that little black circle I talked about. A lot of people ask, how did I get that? Well, QuickTime just does that as long as you select that option there that I showed for showing mouse clicks. So you can see I've got the trackpad button held down, and you can see it puts the circle there to indicate that on the video. So it's a pretty straightforward, easy way to do it. I'm going to close this without saving. I'm going to show you just one more time how it's done, but this time I'm going to click and drag a boxed area. So not only do you get to select an area, but you get to adjust it. See how it has a start recording button in there? But I can drag the edges. So if I just want to capture just a small area, I can certainly do that. And I can do it in an unusual size even to create an unusual movie. And you can see now I can do things in here. I can hit the stop button and I get a QuickTime movie that's that size right there. So really easy to do, really easy to make quick little clips to demonstrate something to somebody, and it's all there in QuickTime Player, which you've got on your Mac right now.